Here are some cheap perf boards or prototyping boards. These are a good choice between circuits on breadboards and an actual printed circuit board. These are more rigid than breadboard circuits and thus can be used for semi-permanent circuits. Value of these versus actual PCBs is time. With these you can get prototype up and running in just few moments. You can test your circuit and easily do any modifications your circuit might need before ordering a proper PCB. If you find yourself using same components in most of your prototypes, consider creating your own custom prototyping board and ordering the PCBs from PCBWAY.com, the sponsor of this video. PCBWAY.com is an affordable PCB manufacturer who offers PCBs starting from just $5 plus shipping for 10 two-layer 100x100mm PCBs. They are a great PCB manufacturer for all your prototyping and low-volume production needs. Now they even offer 3D printing and CNC milling services. Go check out PCBWAY.com. This is the prototyping board I designed. I started by thinking some of the circuits I built on regular protoboards. I came up with the following specs. The 7x5cm board usually has plenty of space, so I'll use those dimensions. The power input should be compatible with most wall boards, so regular DC jack was selected as a connector. I added two options for regulator. LM7800 series through-hole regulator or MCB1700 series SMD regulator in SOT23 package. First column from left is connected to regulator's output, and second one is ground. I can use this unregulated by adding a jumper between two outer pads of LM7800 footprint. It's impossible to be prepared for everything, but I added a footprint for most used SMD IC in my projects, which is SOIC8. It can be connected to the circuit using jumper wires from the pads right next to it. If I want to use two different voltages, I can populate both regulators and cut the trays connecting the VCC pads from the middle. There's no easy way of chaining the regulators, so with 6 volts maximum input of the SOT23 package regulator, I can't utilize it with, for example, common 12 volt power supply. If I had an option to chain these regulators, I could use LM7805 to regulate the input down to 5 volts and then use the SOT23 package regulator to regulate that to 3.3 volts for dual power. Like I said, it's impossible to be prepared for everything. This is a great general purpose prototyping board for my projects, but it's not perfect fit for every situation. And my goal is not to preach how good this exact board is, nor do I want you to get this same board. What I want you to do is to design one for yourself, with all the features that you need. Let's just say, a suit tailored for me will be perfect fit only for me. To get started designing your own prototyping board, you need a grid of through-hole pads with even spacing. At least in KiCad, this is very easy. Start a new project and open the board layout editor. Click Add New Footprint and add footprint called 1x1 No Silk to where you want top left corner of the grid to be. Let's hide the name and value from silk screen by right-clicking the pad, selecting properties and unticking the show from both reference and value. Now right-click on the footprint and select Create Array. Here you can set the size of the grid. I think it is easier to create larger grid than is needed and deleting the extra pads afterwards. Set the horizontal and vertical counts the way you want and set horizontal and vertical spacing to 2.54 mm or 100 mm if you want the usual spacing. When you are done, click OK. Now you should have a nice grid of pads, just like in a prototyping board. If you are designing a circuit in a schematic editor, be careful not to discard this newly created grid. When you select Update PCB from Schematic, annotate the schematic as usual, but don't yet click the Update PCB. Make sure to untick Delete Extra Footprints. Otherwise, components not in the schematic will be deleted from the PCB. Another, maybe better option is to select all the pads in the grid, right-click and select Locking, Lock. This will prevent you from accidentally deleting, moving or altering those pads. If you need to remove some pads to make room for other components, just select pads you want to delete and hit Delete on your keyboard. If the pads are locked, hit Delete again while the notification is visible. So even though this grid is an array made with Array tool, there are still individual pads that you can modify. When you are doing your next PCB order, consider designing yourself a custom prototyping board for quick prototype circuits. Price per board is really reasonable, especially if you are already ordering some PCBs anyway, so you can save on shipping cost. Thanks for watching. I hope this was useful. Thanks. Bye.